Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DVC Technology, and I've got a cool one today. Today, Unifi is releasing the 5.1 version of Protect software. They're releasing three new AI cameras, and they're releasing the AI port, which is going to allow you to connect non-Unifi cameras to Unifi Protect and get AI detections, which is really awesome. And with that, let's jump right into it. So they've released three new cameras, the AI version of the Dome, the AI version of the Turret, and the AI LPR, which looks like the AI Pro, but with maybe a high-pass filter to help with license plate recognition. Really cool stuff. So real quickly, let's go through the specs. The AI LPR is an all-weather 4K PoE Plus camera with 3x optical zoom and long-range IR vision optimized for recognizing license plates on vehicles moving up to 90 kilometers per hour, which is awesome. So it's 4K, 8-megapixel video resolution, 3x optical zoom, 15-meter or 50-foot IR night vision, advanced AI detects people, reads license plates, and more. Records audio with integrated microphone, connect to power using PoE++, and it's weatherproof for outdoor use. I'm not quite sure if this is going to be PoE Plus or PoE++. I'm assuming it's probably going to be PoE++. I'm obviously got the pre-release specs here, so we'll see at the final release whether that's PoE Plus or PoE++. Now onto the AI Turret, which I think is going to be a monster seller for Unifi. It is an all-weather, vandal-proof, 4K PoE Plus turret camera with enhanced AI capabilities and IR and visible LEDs for night vision. It too is 4K 8-megapixel video resolution, ultra-wide viewing angle 109.9 degrees, 40-meter 131 foot IR night vision, advanced AI face license plate recognition, integrated LED spotlight for color night vision, far-field microphone array for two-way audio, micro SD card support for edge recording. The micro SD card must be at least 64 gigs of storage. Connect and power using PoE+, weatherproof, outdoor, exposed. So that's going to be a really cool one. I think that's going to be a big, big, big seller. And then we have the AI Dome, which is an all-weather, vandal-proof 4K PoE dome camera with enhanced AI capabilities and long-range IR night vision. It's all-weather, vandal-proof 4K PoE dome camera with enhanced AI capabilities and long-range IR night vision. Again, it's 4K, 8-megapixel video resolution, ultra-wide viewing angle, 109.9 degrees again, 40-meter, 131-foot IR night vision, advanced AI face and license plate detection, record audio with integrated microphone, micro SD card support for edge recording, connect and power using PoE. It's weatherproof for outdoor exposure. And again, the micro SD card needs to be at least 64 gigabytes. Another cool thing about the turret and the dome is it looks like they're going to come in white and black, which is awesome. Everybody loves that. So I'm really excited about these three cameras. I think these are three cameras that everybody is asking for. The smart AI detections on the dome and the turret are really, really welcome. And as you know, I've done a ton of videos on LPR or license plate recognition, and everybody has been dying to get a dedicated LPR camera. I'm assuming, and this is just a wild guess, that there's going to be an IR cut filter on this camera, which will cut down the reflections on the license plate. So one of the problems with license plate recognition on Unifi cameras, as it is right now, if you see my other videos, is the license plate get blown out. And that will help to reduce that, meaning that you'll get better detections and a better hit rate. So I'm really excited to get my hands on that. And all three of these cameras, I'm really excited to test out. I should have them in hand at some point in the not too distant future. And look forward to me reviewing them. Please like and subscribe if you want to see those videos in the near future. And that brings us to Protect 5.1. A lot of cool stuff in Protect 5.1. The big updates are Alarm Manager, and I'll jump into it. Sensor Manager monitors sensors at scale. I don't have any sensors, so I really can't show you that, but that's cool, and people have been asking for that. Case Manager, so if you do have an incident where you need to write a report or show somebody what happened on the cameras, it lets you do that in kind of an easy and graceful way. It enables powerful incident reporting, gathering relevant clips, adding descriptions, and generating reports, which is what it does. NFC and biometric support for the G4 Doorbell Pro. I don't have that, but I know everybody's been dying for support of that. So congratulations if you have that. It now supports that, which everybody has really been dying to have. And also the Apple TV app is redesigned with single touch setup for easier navigation. Again, I don't use the Apple TV app, but if you have that, congratulations, you're getting a cool upgrade there as well. Those are the main headliners. I'm going to read you a couple other things from the changelog. One of my favorites is the ability to mark specific events as favorites. And when you mark something as a favorite, and I'll show you here in a bit, it will make that not ever erase. So it saves that in perpetuity, really cool. It also added the ability to improve detection precision by reporting false positive detections. That's pretty cool. I'll show you that. It also added support for shortcuts in dewarp mode. If you have one of the 360 cameras, that's a really cool new feature. It also added support for locating detections based on the confidence level, added support for pausing, resuming footage via the spacebar. Really cool one. Added support for loitering detections, another really cool one that everybody's been asking for. Added shortcut to detections from the dashboard, another cool one. Added shortcut to detections from the dashboard, and added the ability to clone alarms in Alarm Manager. There's a bunch of other improvements, so you can read the change log there to see what all is involved with that. But those are the major points. So let's jump into the software real quick, and I'm gonna show you a few of these things in action. So let's jump into Alarm Manager here, and you'll see that it looks just like it normally did here, but when you create a new alarm, you'll see the whole new interface, which is really cool. Basically, you're able to have a trigger, a scope, and an action. So let's just say on activity, and we'll say motion or line crossing. Let's just go motion here. On the AI theta, and I'm going to notify, right? So that's cool. On LPR, a known unknown vehicle, known vehicle, vehicle of interest. This is basically all the thing that people have been asking me is, can it notify me if I don't know the person, if I do know the person, or that kind of thing. Same thing with face ID, unknown person, known person, person of interest, specific face. You can now say if an unknown face on my AI DSLR shows up to notify me or to turn on a light or a webhook. It's really cool. And I can see them building this out further than they are now. So I can have it notify people. I can have it notify specific people. I can have it notify everybody. Really cool stuff here. I can have it control a light, and I can how long it's going to do that light. Really, really cool stuff in here. I highly recommend, even if you don't use this a lot, jump in here and play with it, because it is really powerful the way they've designed this. More of this kind of if-then kind of situation, and I can see them adding and building this out even more and more as they develop the product. So super excited about this. I think for most of my clients, this is a major addition to be able to know when certain things happen. You don't want to know all the time, but let's just say if an unknown person walks into an area that's protected, or you know, an unknown vehicle comes down my driveway, that's the kind of stuff that my clients are always asking me for detections on, and now it's built in here, which is amazing. Really cool stuff. Another addition is Case Manager. I don't deal with this quite as much. I'm gonna discard that. I don't deal with this quite as much. You can see I did a test case in here, but let's create a new case. All right, so let's just take, I created that case. Now let me add a video to that case. So I'm gonna go ahead and click here. And this is Silva leaving the building. She's my person of interest. I'm gonna go ahead and click on add to a case. It's going to ask which case. I just created that case 01, and I'm gonna add it to it. Then I'm gonna go and say, oh, you know what? This is Silva before she was leaving. I'm gonna go ahead and add that to the case as well. And I'll add that to the case. And now I'm gonna go back into the case manager over here. And now I've got these two instances, and I can add some text in here and just say whatever I needed to say. But what I've got now is this built out. So I can add multiple videos. I can put my annotations into it, and then I can download this. So I went ahead and unzipped that, and you can see what they put in here is a PDF. So you can see this is a nice PDF, and in the same folder, it exported the two videos. So if I was, you know, reporting this to the police or reporting this to the security or whatever I need to, I could come in here, quickly make a case, present it quite well, and then send it off. Nice addition. I don't know, for me, it's not the biggest addition in the world, but there have been several times where I have had to go to recordings and give them to the police. So this would be a great way to do that in a kind of just a package, a zipped up file that I can just send off to them. So cool stuff there. Unfortunately, like I said before, I don't have any sensors here to show you the sensor stuff, and I don't have a G4 doorbell, so I can't show you that as well. But one other thing I did mention there was favorite. So if I just go into my regular detections, I can click on any one of these, and there's this new flag, and I can click on this flag, and it's going to add it to my favorites. And what I'm able to do there is this, you know, as time goes by and this would roll off and be deleted, it will never be deleted. This is now in my saved in my favorites for forever until I delete it. And then even better than that, I now have this flagged up here where I can click on that, and it's going to show me anything that I favorited, which is really cool. Pretty simple stuff, but really cool stuff. One other simple but cool addition too is the spacebar now stops and pauses during playback. Really cool little addition. It's not going to change the world, but sometimes it's the little things that really help. That's the bulk of the updates. I highly recommend downloading 5.1, though, when it comes into general release. There are a lot of cool improvements in here, and I think most people will benefit from many of them. Last thing I want to talk about is the AI port. I think a lot of people have been waiting for this device. It's an AI appliance that enhances any Unifi or third-party camera with AI detection, classification, and recognition capabilities. The cool thing about it is it also works on Unifi cameras. So if you have an old G3, G4, or G5 that did not have detections before, you can add this unit to it and get those AI detections, which is awesome. People have been asking me for years when and if they'd ever be able to use non-Unifi cameras in Protect, and that time is now. So that is awesome. This device is compatible with ONVIF third-party cameras. It has advanced AI with face and license plate recognition. It's PoE++/PoE+ power input and one PoE++/PoE power output. So what it sounds to me like that is it's going to take power in and it's going to step it down one plus. So if you have plus plus, it'll go out on plus. And if you had PoE plus, it's just going to drop it down to regular PoE. I'm assuming it's going to be able to power itself with that and then power the camera on the end, which is awesome. And you're able to directly connect or pair with cameras on the network. Another really cool thing is there's going to be an AI port rack mount. So let's just say you have three or four or five cameras that you need to deploy these on. You're going to be able to put these in a nice, tidy rack mountable unit and cable manage that and have it look really nice. So that is amazing. I think a lot of people are going to be very excited about this, and I have a feeling this one is going to fly off the shelves as well. So that about wraps it up. This is a really cool announcement from Unifi. I'm really excited about the three cameras. The AI port is going to be a hot commodity, and the free updates to Protect 5.1 are really going to be awesome. And with that, if you have any questions or comments or things you want me to review on these cameras when I get my hands on it, please put them in the comments down below. I read all of them, and I really do use those as inspiration for how I'm doing my camera reviews. So if you do have a question about any of these cameras, please put it down below. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.